Welcome back, survivors, to episode 2 of Ark Scorched Earth multiplayer. How's everyone doing today? So I haven't been able to meet up with Midnight Designer yet. I don't think he's been able to sit down yet and get a place. I actually have to go and watch his episodes. But from what I've learned, are you going over to my place? Please stay over here. Yes, please. Don't go. Ah, damn it. Okay, so I have to catch up on his episodes. Apparently he hasn't been able to get a place yet, and I fully understand that. This took a lot of time and a lot of patience on my behalf, but hey, it's a learning lesson, right? And what I also learned is you cannot tame those water jug bugs. So huge lesson learned on that one. I kind of get it, though. It'd be too easy if you could just grab a water bug and bring it back to your base with you. So, other plans. It seems those big guys with the humps, what we can do with them is tame them and then drink from their humps. So, problem solved. What we're going to do today is try to find ourselves one of them so that we can have a good water supply at the base and just get down to making a base here and getting settled in, because freaking water is a struggle. The struggle is real. So let's go for a little bit of a walk here. Hopefully I don't die of dehydration too fast. I'm going to try to stick pretty close to base in case I do die so I can find my sheet again. But what do we got over here? Is that one? It is one. Okay, cool. So I need to make myself a bola. I don't even think I have enough materials on me to make a bola. I actually just recently died before I started this episode. I logged in and totally forgot I was logged in, and I was talking away on YouTube, replying to comments, and I came back. I was like, oh, shoot, I'm in the game. I came back. I was dead from being too hot, so that's how that goes. Alright, yeah, we're gonna have to go back to base here and make a bola, and the bola should work on these guys. I don't see why it wouldn't, but we'll give her a try. You guys might be screaming at the monitor right now, or you guys might be like, good idea, Skippy, should have done that the first time on your first playthrough. Hey, we all forget stuff, right? Alright, let's get up here and see what's going on in our inventory. I'm glad that this one really, really close. Oh, Chirpoa, you know what? You're going to be my buddy, too. Now, these guys, you could just punch out. Cool. So I'm going to tame this guy here. I should have a few narco berries on me. I have major berries. I'll take those. It looks like I'm going to have to get some more berries, too, because they all expired in my inventory while I was offline. The disadvantages of playing multiplayer. You can't just log off and have everything just go away, you know what I mean? It is kind of convenient when that happens, but right now is not that time. Sweet, so we got a Jabur. I also lost my fire pit. It was over here somewhere, and now it's gone. I don't know what the heck happened to it. Do animals or dinosaurs attack fire pits? Is that a thing? Is it like I had it tucked over in the corner over here when I was first trying to get settled in, and I would hide in this corner and keep an eye out because I didn't have to watch behind me, but now that sucker's gone. And I also have to make a mortar and pistols so I can, you know, I can start making some trank arrows, because I'm almost there with the level, and I also have one trank arrow that I looted off a dinosaur, so it's nice to see a lot of loot coming off these dinosaurs. Alright, let's go check up on our Jerboa here. This is a classic. You guys have to get one of these right away. I mean, they sit on your shoulder and they're freaking cool. And you can put hats on them. I mean, anything you can put a hat on is good in my books. Okay, what are we at here? We'll keep his torpor. Torpor? Is it torpor? I don't even know how to say half this crap. I'm gonna have to look it up, or like maybe watch how other people say it and emulate them, unless they're wrong. That would suck. Ah, sweet, you got even closer. Come down here, buddy. I would love if you came to see us. That would be awesome. So I should have a lot of spoiled meat as well here, too. It definitely appears as if I'm gonna need food. Oh, well, berries will do. But we're gonna have to kill an animal here soon as well, too. Grabbing some berries. Might kill one of those suckers. I don't know if these guys attack in pairs. If you attack one, if the other one will attack you. But I tried killing one that was stuck in a rock, and the XP on these things are insane. Wow. Remember I was telling you guys about how my keyboard gets stuck? It's doing it right now. I'm not pressing the W button. Alright, so I got that fixed up. Found out what was wrong. What happened was I have a USB hub. I have like a 6-foot USB cable going from my computer to a hub, and then I have my mic and my keyboard and everything plugged in over by my couch. And what it was is the power plug actually pulled out of that hub, and while it didn't have enough power to power all the devices, and it went all weird. But whatever, lesson learned, big oops, let's get rolling. We did lose our Jerboa. That is unfortunate. We don't have a tamed Jerboa, but that is okay. We can do some other stuff here. Let's see what we got. Looks like the area sorted itself out a little bit. So there's one of those suckers. They look like they hit fucking hard. But I would assume these are great for mining. I don't know. Maybe we'll tame one at some point, use it for mining. I'll have to take a look, because each and every dinosaur is basically a little different. That's what I do like about this game, is the difference and stuff. Oh, yes. You know what I was on the way of doing, or way to do, was build that bola. And then we got distracted by my cute little friend over here. So let's go take care of that. I probably don't have any more narco berries either. I keep pressing tab instead of inventory. Okay, what do we have here? 7 narco berries. Damn it. Okay. Looks like they expired in that time as well here too. Scorched earth, it seems everything expires quite quickly. Am I getting hungry? No, I'm okay on hunger, but I'm going to need some water soon. How are we doing down there for water? For any carnivorous activities? Doesn't seem like there's much trouble down there. I only see a few friendlies, so let's go check that out, and I'll grab berries on the way down. That's the best thing to do. 2 things at once, right? Man, this map, I'm glad I bought Scorched Earth. I was really, really fighting it because of the whole paid DLC for an alpha game, which I am not a big fan of, but I took a look at it, and God, I'm glad I bought this. It's so beautiful. Like, the art map, it's nice. But this one, it touches me in a special place. Okay, here we are. Oh, and of course, we got a nice big old water bug right by the water hole. Just got to tease me, don't you? Or are you refilling, too? Everyone's got to refill, I guess. Okay. So, sweet. Got some water. Thought I heard some movement. No, we're good to go. That's awesome. This place is actually generally pretty clear of any threat. That's not too bad. All you have to do in your area is just make sure you keep it clear. If you see something new spawn in or a new carnivore move into the territory, take it out right away. Then you won't get 2 or 3, which can really cause a problem, especially if you're lower level like I am. And a level 5 can still pose quite a challenge. Okay, how many berries do we have here? You know what we should do? Make a mortar and pestle too, and just do arrows. Yeah, I guess I could just do arrows. That might be easier instead of the narco berries to put it out. Or the narco berries to put it out. I mean, instead of, like, punching it or hitting it with a club to put it out. It looks like our little Jerboa friend is stuck there permanently anyways. And he has Tourette's, so I'm going to come back to him later once I find a doctor. All right, let's get up here and get our shit together here. So we need to make a... you know what? Do I even have that unlocked? Let's check this out. I actually didn't. So let's learn that. Derp. And I need to make a new fireplace as well, too, because that's gone for some reason. Unless it was in a different spot and I'm just remembering it wrong. That's a complete possibility as well. Okay, so I'm going to look up fire here. And what do we not have on me? Oh, we don't have any supplies on me that I need for that type of thing. So I'm going to grab up some fiber here. Go over here. And grab up the rest of the supplies. So we needed fiber and thatch? Do we need thatch? Oh, wait. No, we should be good. We should be good. Oh, maybe not. What the hell am I missing? Thatch? God damn it. All right, let's go get some thatch, and then we should be able to make this sucker. What? Check one more time. And what do we need for this as well, too? Hide. Okay, we do have hide. So we are good to, go on that. And we need to make the fire. Why am I pulling a brain fart here? Okay, I don't have 2 wood. That's okay. I'll grab that when I'm out anyways. Flint? Did I not move this shit over to my inventory? Is shit going missing? It is too. Oh no, here's my flint. I'm an idiot. And here's some thatch. I'm like looking in the wrong inventory here, guys. Wow, I'm completely proud of what I just did. And I'm going to throw the hide on me as well too, so we can make both at the same time. Okay, so we need more stone that I can do. You know what? I'm going to make the fire first, and then we'll go grab some stone, just so I can make the rest here. Fire! God damn it. Okay. Move the wood over. I wish you could just slide this over in the craftables menu. That would be really, really freaking nice. And what else don't I have? Wait, what are you telling me I don't have? I don't have thatch? Fuck off. I swore I moved thatch over to my inventory. Not enough. Okay. Okay. What is going on here? You know what? I can just make the mortar and pestle first. You guys are probably watching this going, Skippy, what the fuck are you doing, man? Okay. Here we go. We'll craft that. Get that down first so I can start getting some stuff going on here. Because I should also have spoiled meat all over the place. I don't know where it would have went if I didn't. But here we go. Okay, so I still need stones and I still need some thatch. So I'm going to go and grab that stuff up. Here we go. And this should be my last slot. I'm going to put this actually in between over here, you know. Oh, wait. That's right. It needs to go on the floor. Yeah, picky bastard. All right, so hopefully that shit doesn't get destroyed. There we go. Let's look for ourselves for some meat. What do we got going on in here? Where'd all my spoiled meat go? Did I get robbed? Midnight Designer, have you stopped by my base? Did you rob me? Where the heck's all my spoiled meat? This makes no sense to me. All my spoiled meat's gone. Where would it have went? Oh, well, that's a shame. Okay, well, it looks like I have my work set out for me here. So what I'm going to do, guys, it's turning out nighttime. I'm going to go ahead and, of course, stop the recording for the night. I'm going to go and get together whatever I need to make these trank arrows. Apparently, I need some meat, so I'm going to have to kill something. And what else do I need here? We need meat and a fire pit. That's right. So I got to go get some thatch and other basic supplies. So I'm going to cut this out, and I will see you guys shortly after this break. Thanks for watching me derp. Oh man, I had to record this. My first lightning storm. I have not seen one of these lightning storms yet. This is absolutely gorgeous. I'm actually gonna switch to a weapon here, or a tool. There we go, less light, more lightning. Oh, I love it. That is freaking cool. That is so cool. Oh, and I don't even have to hide out. It doesn't seem as if the storms in this area, because I'm not really receiving any negative effects. You know, I'm cold, but that's the average for a night. Maybe it's not storming on this part? I don't know. Are lightning storms supposed to hurt you? I don't even know what's going on. But that just looks freaking awesome. Okay, so since we're here, I may as well freaking show you guys here. I've started making some narcotics. I had to go and learn the narcotic, of course. That's why I keep the extra XP on me, the extra engrams, in case there's something I'm like, oh, whoops. I don't just spend them willy-nilly and accidentally spend something I need. But I got the raw meat in here. It's slowly spoiling, and I'm making narcotics as we go. And I'm pretty much just waiting out the night right now. Not much I can do at the moment because it's cold. It's storming. And I'm waiting on shit. So I'm gonna once again cut it here, guys, and I'll see you right after this break. And a pleasant morning to everybody. So we're back. Lightning storm's over. It's all done with. You got the remnants of it hanging around. But we are good to go. It's nice and clear. I've gone ahead. I've made a couple bolas. And I've also made 6 narcotics so that we can put it in its inventory. These work a lot better than doing the berries. It's so much easier. So hopefully 6 narcotics is going to be good enough to take out one of those suckers. I actually forget what their name is. I'm going to call them my hump buddies. So we have to go get one of my hump buddies today, but of course I need to touch myself up on water. I'm about halfway down. Now I did notice on the overnight, oh, he's over there right against the wall. Sweet, that'll be nice and easy. On the overnight, I started eating berries to fill myself up because I was like, well, fuck, I got so much. And I noticed when it's cold out, the berries actually do increase your water. They don't do it when it's hot. Maybe it's because it doesn't increase it quickly enough, and that it actually reduces quicker than it increases, so you don't actually see the increase of water. So that's kind of new. Maybe that's the same thing with the cactus sap as well, too. Maybe you have to eat it when it's cold, because it's got such a small water gain that you can't... That you can't even notice it. Aw, that looks so cool. My fire up there going. Now it's easier at night too to see where I am. So that's why I was also having my fireplace going over there. I'm still kind of choked about the fire pit and all my spoiled meat. Everything's gone. All right, well here we go. It's time to give her down. I'm gonna actually like punch this guy out because I forgot to make a wooden club. Oh, we might not take out these guys. I forgot about that. Okay. Fist it is. Fist of Fury. There you go. What was their name? Morellatops? There you go, Morellatops. Suck it, bitch. Yeah, I should be able to punch this guy out. He's only level 7. Watch a freaking carnivore coming out of nowhere and freaking kill me. Oh, that would suck. I've had that happen before. And they took the dino I was trying to tame. God damn it. Well, this guy ain't fighting back at all. We can definitely take him out by punching him. Thank God he got stuck on something. Ooh, he's unconscious. Okay, we are good to go. Let's access inventory. There we are. Nice. We have ourselves a Morellatops now. All right. So his topar is going to be going down. And I'm honestly just going to start pumping berries into them, whatever. Now, I think you guys said the mejo berry is the best way to go as far as taming them. Do they eat the one that's in the first slot or the one that's further down? I don't even know, but I guess we'll find out with some trial and error. So, of course, I'm going to stick around this area here and hang out while this guy is taming because I don't want the dinosaur to eat them. That's not cool. Holy shit, this guy's gonna take a while to tame, that's for sure. Look at that tame bar move. Okay, cool. And I heard one move. And I know there's other ways to do this as well, too. Like, if you let them starve and then do all that. Honestly, I just find it's easier to do it this way. Then I can go around and do other stuff. At low levels, it doesn't really matter to me. If I was capturing a really, really high-level dinosaur, a really valuable dinosaur, I think I'd put that extra effort in. But for, like, something that's going to turn out to be, like, level 10 or 11, no big deal. Oh, look at that. Now it has a water thing above it. Now that I'm taming it, that is friggin' awesome. Even the topar doesn't go down very fast. Whoops. I grabbed at something instead of opening up his inventory. Here we go. Let's check that out. Wait. Fill water tank from inventory. What is this? Definitely not me. Access inventory. Okay, what do we got in here? So it's topor. What we're going to do is remote use one of these items. I think that should be a little overkill, actually. Let's see what it gets up to here. Yeah, it was a little overkill. Okay, whatever. At least he's good for now. We'll have to keep coming back to him because he's going to be laying there for a while. So hopefully this area stays pretty neutral for now. How far are we from the water pit? Ah, we're a good distance from the water and actually pretty close to home. Oh, wow. We couldn't have asked for a better area for this guy to go down in. That's freaking awesome. So I'm going to go ahead and keep gathering stuff. Got the grind going on. And once this guy is good to go, we will ride it. We'll go and get some water for it to drink. And you know what? I'm going to see if I can make a saddle for this guy as well, too, while we're waiting. I will see you guys right after this break and when we have ourselves a wild Morellatops, or a tamed one. I'll see you guys very shortly. Man, it's like Canada, but with snow. Or with sand instead of snow. Holy crap. And of course, this guy is almost done taming. And this shit starts up. As usual. Oh my god. Well, let's hope for the best. And let's hope some shit doesn't get in our way. Because that would really, really suck. There we go. Yay, we have our first animal. We now have a Morellatops. Let's name our friend Hump Buddy. There we go. Because he's got two humps, and it's actually a she as well, too, so that kind of works out. My hump buddy's a girl. Okay, so I do not know how to get this thing filled up with water, so we are going to set this thing Change name, access inventory. Actually, what do you have in your inventory here? Oh, okay, I just have a couple of narcotics. Now, I did have to go and make more narcotics, but that's okay, because I had so much time on my hands to do that. So maybe you have to ride this thing in order for it to do it, or it just automatically fills with water. That we're going to have to find out. Holy shit. Oh, okay, it's level 9. I was going to say level 19, but I'm reading my own damn level. Now, I can't even make... You know what? Let's get this guy back to base here. Let's get him going. I have to quickly look up the keys here again. So T is follow and U is stop. I always have to look those up. I always press the wrong ones. All right, come follow me, buddy. Through this sandstorm of ours. Good God, this is bad. Is this what sandstorms are actually like? Jesus, that must hurt. Like, I know it takes down your stamina, but I think a sandstorm should hurt a little as well, too. I mean... You're pretty much having sandpaper grind up against your face. That's gotta hurt a bit, you know what I mean? And it's not like I'm incredibly covered up. There you are, buddy. Keep coming to me. Come on, Hump Butter. Good God, this could be the worst day to inaugurate you. Well, whatever. I guess this is a decent inauguration, right? Right? There you go, Hump Buddy. Should have made you Trump Buddy. There we go. Maybe one animal will get named after our friend there. All right, let's move on here and get this guy over back to my base. Ooh, another thing I realized too, I have those stupid spikes sitting right there. So I'm not sure I'm going to be able to get this guy to come up to my base. And the other thing is as well... Is I don't have... I learned how to make it. What if I bring them in this way? At least over to the side here. Here you go. Come over here so you're beside the spikes. So that way if anything goes down, you know, there's a little bit of defense at least. Oh, well, let's see what happens here. Oh, I can't even jump right now. This is bad because my stamina's done. All right, so I'm going to look at you. And you're going to stay. How you doing, Hump Bunny? Oh, you're so pretty. I'm glad you're mine. Alright, are you going to make me water, though? Is this how this works? I don't even know how this works. Come on, Hump Buddy. Produce water. Okay, so it looks like my next challenge is going to be getting together some more hide in order to make a saddle for this guy. Oh my God, I can't even get up to my place in the sandstorm. Bad design. Bad design. Oh well, this should be over pretty soon here. Oh, and I'm running out of water. This is never good. Okay. So what I'm going to do is push my way through the sandstorm again and go down to this watering hole. All right. So let's talk about future plans here. I do plan on making several different buildings. I'm not going to just like make one base and call it a day. There's going to be different bases doing different things. You know what I mean? It'll be fun, like a greenhouse and a main house and a barn and a stable. And you know what? Can you mate those little cute guys you put on your shoulder? Because if you can, I seriously want to make 1,000 of them. Just have 1,000 going on in their own little breeding house. You better not be following me. Okay, we're good. We're good. We left them up at the top. We just have to get some water here. How long do these storms last? It ain't no thing. I'll just walk in it. Hopefully, I'm headed in the right direction here, too. I can't even see shit. We got a tree there, so that's a good sign. Trees are always good. Come on, storm. Break. I also need to go and make some more bows and arrows as well, too. It turns out those little armadillo-looking things with a badass spike at the end of their tail, those guys are pretty fucking hefty. I tried to kill that one that was stuck in the landscape, and then I found another one stuck in the landscape, and I just couldn't kill it. I kept hitting it. The stupid thing just wouldn't die. So, yeah, that was fun. Oh, my God. I guess I should just stop moving in the sandstorm, and I won't die of thirst, because moving is making me really thirsty here. It's got to be down this way. I'm pretty sure it's down this way. Man, this is like the draw distance of 7 days to die on PS4 prior to the most recent patch. This is brutal. Okay, where are you, watering hole? I know you're down here somewhere. I think it's right over here. It's got to be right over here. If it's not, well, it's going to be some bad, bad news. Where are you, watering hole? God, I can't even find it. I'm lost. Oh, there it is. There it is. I found it. I found you, watering hole. Nice. We shall live to see another day. Well, that's pretty exciting, guys. We got our first dinosaur trained. I got a few more pieces put up on my building while I was waiting for it to tame. And other than that, everything is like good to go. So that pretty much wraps up this episode, guys. I'm glad you're enjoying these episodes. I'll keep making them as long as you guys keep enjoying them. And as usual, I want to remind you, back up your game saves, stay classy, and I'll see you in the next episode. Have a good one, guys. Hit it, you bunch of dirty hippies. Oh, and look at that. Surfer's going down.